गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
माय नेम इज मुकेश
अच्छा
कुमार एंड आई एम डब्ल्यू सेट लेवल 3 सर्टिफाइड सोमेलियर एंड आई बीन वर्किंग विद सुला फॉर लास्ट 6 ईयर्स। सो टुडे वील टॉक अबाउट द वाइन, वील डिस्कस अबाउट द वाइन, व्हाट इज वाइन, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ वाइन एंड हाउ वाइन्स आर मेड, राइट? सो इन केस यू हैव एनी क्वेरी, सो यू कैन आस्क मी लेटर आफ्टर द सेशन इन क्वेश्चन आंसर राउंड। ओके, तो बेसिकली वाइन इट्स काइंड ऑफ अल्कोहलिक बेवरेज। इट कंटेन्स अल्कोहल 8 to 15% इन स्टिल एंड स्पार्कलिंग वाइन एंड इट कैन गो अप टू 20% 22% इन फोर्टिफाइड वाइन। सो व्हाट इज वाइन बेसिकली? इट्स एन अल्कोहलिक बेवरेज, इट कंटेन्स अल्कोहल, राइट? समथिंग इज देयर इन द बॉटल दैट इज अल्कोहल विच इज कंप्लीटली मेड आउट ऑफ ग्रेप जूस और ग्रेप मस्ट। In case you're making wine from grape juice, that is a white wine. And in case you're fermenting the grape must, then you're making a red wine. Am I audible to all of you? Is it okay?
Yes,
Guys? Okay, fine.
yes, so
Secondly, it's been fermented. So you have grape juice or grape must, you need to ferment it by adding yeast. Yeast start taking the sweetness from the grape juice. What do you think? Grape juice has some sweetness or not? Yes,
yes,
it
sir.
has some
Yes, sir.
sweetness. And the same sweetness is converted into alcohol and it also releases some CO2. Okay? So yeast react on the sweetness and convert the sweetness into alcohol. That's how we can make a wine basically, right? So now classification of wine. I'll take you to the classification of wine. Wine can be classified into three categories: types of wine, body of wine, and style of wine. Types of wine are still wine, sparkling wine, and fortified wine. You can see it on your screen. So types of wine are still wine, sparkling wine, and fortified wine. And majority of red, white, and rosé wine are still. Basically, they don't have CO2 inside the bottle. It's in a still state. Right? Okay. So basically, these are the classification of wines: still wines, red, white, and rosé. Wine, you can see they are red wine, they are white wine, they are rosé wine, right? So the wine has no CO2 inside the bottle. You must have seen. You must have been drinking beer, right? So what do you see in the beer? There's CO2. That makes it very refreshing and it makes it a bit crispy, right? And whenever you see a beer has no CO2, no bubbles are there, it means it's a flat beer. Okay? But in case of wine, what do you think? What do you see? There is a wine which has no CO2 and there is another wine which has CO2. So the wine you have CO2, it has flavors. It has natural flavors. It has natural taste. It has a good body, nice structure is there in the wine. It smells like blossoms, flowers, fruits, food. So that is a very fine wine. So that's how you can judge your wine basically. And it has no bubbles. Okay? It has no bubbles. It's still in state. That is a still wine. Okay? Then we have sparkling wine. Sparkling wine has CO2 inside the bottle, which is tapped from the fermentation process. You know, when you're making wine, yeast is added and it started eating the sweetness and convert it into alcohol. Okay? And it also leads CO2. So the same CO2 is tapped inside the bottle. And this wine can be made by two methods. First is the tank method. Second is the bottle fermentation method. It means sparkling wine can be made by two methods: tank fermentation method and the bottle fermentation method. The bottle you can see on the screen, the first bottle, can you see it? Sula Brut Tropical, guys?
Yes,
sir. Yes. So
there is
a wine. This is sparkling wine. But let me tell you, this wine is made by tank fermentation method now. Earlier, we have been making a wine from bottle fermentation method. You know champagne?
Yes, sir.
You know champagne? Champagne is from France, right? Champagne is made from Chardonnay, Pinot Noir, and Pinot Meunier grapes, and they have their own unique style to make it. What is that style? They make a dry wine first. Dry means the wine has no CO2. From which grapes? Chardonnay, Pinot Noir, and Pinot Meunier. These three grapes are used. They make a dry wine. Simple fermentation किया जाता है. They make a dry wine, and that dry wine is bottled. You can sorry. Okay, the wine you can see on the screen, same style of bottle, the same type of bottle. They bottle the wine and they crown it. They keep the bottle for fermentation process. 18 months. So wine is fermenting inside the bottle itself for 18 months. That's how they make a champagne. And we earlier used to making kind of wine, and the brand name for the wine name is Sula Brut only. But the wine you can see on the skin is Sula Brut Tropical. This is made by tank fermentation method. It's simply in a tank, you have grapes, you add some juice, you add some yeast in it, and it starts fermenting. Okay? And once the fermentation is done, it's bubbly, it has very freshness, the factor is there, and you bottle under pressure. That's it. Then you have fortified wines. The wine has the wines are 45 basically. The wines are fortification. Addition of alcohol is done. Addition of guys, please keep quiet. The addition of alcohol is done during the fermentation process. Guys, if you're talking, you can mute your mic, please. Okay, addition of alcohol is done. In case they're making sherry, you know, the sherry and port are the good example of fortified wines. Give me a moment, let me control. Okay. Right. So addition of alcohol is done. See, in fortified wine, you can see the alcoholic strength can go up to 22% in fortified wines. And in still and sparkling wine, the alcoholic strength would be up to 15% only in still and sparkling wine. Or in fortified wine, the alcoholic strength can go up to 22%. And how it can increase the alcoholic strength? Basically, by adding the alcohol in it. Once they add alcohol during fermentation process, the process can take up to 12 days. The fermentation process of making wine, of any kind of wine, it can take up to 12 days, and depending on the climate, the temperature and everything, right? So during the fermentation, when they add alcohol during the fermentation, they're making port. It means they're halting the fermentation process and they're making it a sweet wine. Port is always sweet. And once they add alcohol after the fermentation process, right, then they're making a sherry. So sherry is always the dry wine. So now that dry wine means there is no sweetness. Okay, if I'm saying that is a dry wine, it means there is no sweetness. On the screen you can see there is Chenin Blanc Reserve, second wine. So this is a white wine, right? And let me tell you, this is a reserve wine, Chenin Blanc, and this is a dry wine. There is no sweetness. You cannot notice any kind of sweetness on your palate when you taste it. The third wine you can see, that is a rosé wine, Zinfandel Rose. That is off dry wine. It has some sweetness. It has some sweetness in it, right? It's an off dry wine. Then you have Tindori Shiraz. That is a red dry wine. Now body of the wine, body could be the density of the wine, viscosity of the wine. It could be light, medium, and full. Basically, light-bodied wines, majority of white wines are light-bodied wines. The wine are feeling on your palate. The taste are like, you can compare it with water. If it feels like water, the thickness of the wine feels like water, then it's a light-bodied wine. With heavy like milk, it's a medium-bodied wine. More heavy like full cream milk, that is a full-bodied wine. So you have red wine, Dindori Shiraz on the screen, you can see that is a full-bodied wine. It's robust, very strong one. And the grape used for making this wine is the Shiraz. And you know, the best grape which is grown in India is Shiraz. Okay. Now style is dry of the medium and sweet. So मैंने आपको बता दिया, right? Dry wine has no sweetness at all. Off dry wine had some sweetness and the sweet wine had some plenty of sweetness. Now, how to make a wine? Wine बनाते कैसे? First of all, a sampling is done. Sampling means something to check the sugar level. A wine maker checks the sugar level and the acidity level in a grape berry. Based on that, harvesting dates are determined. Then they harvest the grapes. In India, we harvest the grapes from Jan to March. That is our harvesting season for grapes. Okay. So we harvest the grapes and we send the grapes to winery. In the winery, there are two types of process. First is the pressing and second is the crushing. Pressing is basically grapes are pressed and juice is squeezed out. If we require the juice, only we're making a white wine. We have a juice, whatever is left, that can be taken for cattle feed. So making some cosmetic products as well, right? But we need to take the juice for making a white wine, right? So there is no pulp, no skin, no seeds. What we require for making white wine? We just require the juice, okay? So now you have a juice. Yeast is added in the juice. Fermentation is started. Once fermentation is over, once it's done, your white wine is ready. It's done. You just need to stabilize the temperature of the wine by bulk sealing method, and you can bottle it basically, because we don't age white wines in India. Aging is not done here in India for white wines. So we can filter it and we can bottle it, we can label it, and we can send it to the market. So you can see within a month you can finish the whole process of making white wine, from sampling to from bottling, from labeling. It can take 30 days for making white wine, for white wine. But for red wine, it can take up to 1 year. Aging makes a big difference. Aging can take up to 1 year, up to 2 years, right? So we don't age white wine. So that's why the processing of making white wine, the red wine, is just for 30 days. The only thing that makes a difference is the aging. We have to do the aging in red wines. Now, how to make red wine? Red grapes are crushed. They make must. Crushing is something soft pressing the grapes in a tank, right? So in a tank, you have a juice of the grapes. You have pulp, basically red grapes. Pulp, skin, seed, stalk, everything is there. The whole component of the grapes are mixed together, and this mixture is called must. Okay? Then must is taken for fermentation. Yeast is added in the in the tank, and it starts fermenting. It can take up to 12 days. When all the must has fermented, then you need to press it. When you're making a white wine, pressing is done before fermentation. Here in case of making red wine, pressing is done. Pressing is simply taking out the juice. It's done after the fermentation. So what you have now, you have a fermented grape juice, which is dark, will be red in color. It's got some alcohol, some grape characteristics are there. Some taste is there, right? But the color is very dark, right? So now what you need to do, you need to age this fermented must. And how you can age a wine? Into oak wood barrels. So we don't have oak tree in India. So we import the barrel from France and America, and we age the wine into oak wood barrels. And the aging should be done at least for 1 year. Why aging is required? We need to cut down the sharpness of the tannins. Tannins, you had some jamun, the dry, numb sensation on your gums. It's just because of tannin. So when a fermented must is pressed, then you have that juice. It's very harsh. The strength of the tannins are very strong. So to cut down that strength, to make it mellow, to make it so smooth and mellow, you need to age the wine into oak wood barrel. Once it's aged, you can filter it and you can bottle the wine and you can send it to the market. So that's how you can make your red wine. So guys, making wine making is clear? Yes or no? Now let's talk about wine storage. Wine storage is where do you store your wine in? Okay, wine storage. So what temperature do we require for storing a wine? We require 15 degree centigrade for all type of wines. Where you can store it? You can store it in wine cellar, in a wine store where you have 15 degree centigrade and humidity should be there. You know, there are cork. You can see on the screen there are some cork, right? These cork require the humidity basically. Okay, so that it doesn't drying out. If it's that dry, then air can get in. Why? Because it's made out of wood, and wood get porous. Once it's dry, okay, then air can get in. If air can get in, your wine could be oxidized. Basically, what you need to do, you need to prevent the air to get in, so that you can preserve your wine. Right? Oxygen ke air ke contact mein aapki wine nahi aani chahiye. If you're storing the wine, if it's get contact with oxygen, then it start oxidizing. Okay, no sunlight should be there in dark and cool place at a stable place. It should not be touched with the machinery. The vibrate hoti rehti hai, jo ki aapki wine ko kharab kar sakti hai, right? And the position. In what position do you store your wine? If it's an under cork wine, the wine has a cork to close the bottle, you can store your wine laying down position or in vertical position. And in case you have a screw cap concept, screw cap to store to close the bottle, then you can store your wine anyhow. Okay, vertically or horizontally. So screw cap concept was introduced by Sula in India, right? Very easy. You don't need to worry about a cork taint, and it maintains the freshness of the wine. Basically, you like export to these countries, and this is the serving temperature for wine. At what temperature do you serve your wine? So let me tell you, you are not chilling the wine. You are chilling the acidity in a wine. Let me tell you, white wine has the highest amount of acidity, and red wine has very low amount of acidity. Do you understand what is acidity, guys? Acidity is something when you have, like, you having citrus fruits, your mouth is watering. It's just because of acidic nature. Lemon is in acidic nature. Is of acidic nature, right? So white wines are acidic, refreshing. Green fruits and green fruits kind of taste and flavors are there in the wine. And red wine has red fruits, black fruits, low in acidity, right? High in tannin. Structure strong hota hai. Body high hoti hai. Medium to full bodied body wines ki hoti hai. Okay. So for sparkling wine, it's 6 to 8 degrees centigrade. For white to rosé wine, 10 to 14 degrees centigrade. And dessert wine, 6 to 8 degrees centigrade. Okay. Wine is good for health. Yes, it's very good for your health. It's good for digestion process. It's good for blood circulation process. It blocks the fatty cell in your stomach. It makes you slim. It's very good actually. Rakshasa is a kind of Ayurvedic tonic which is prescribed to many Indians for centuries. It's still available in Indian market. And the base of making Rakshasa is the grapes, the fermented grapes basically. Right? When the wines were not invented in the world, in this world, at that time, Indians had invented the Rakshasa. It was invented in 3rd or 4th century. Resveratrol is something that's flushing bad cholesterol out of your body, and it protects against cancer as well. So it's very good for your health, but it doesn't mean you having a full bottle every day. Okay, a glass a day is good enough, and the quantity of the glass is 150 ml. This is the standard portion for a wine. Okay, in case you have any query, you can contact us on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram. We do teach WSET courses, wine and spirit education courses. Basically, there are 5 level of WSET. If you want to be wine sommelier, WSET level 1, 2, 3, and 4 you need to clear. Okay, and we have been doing here WSET level 1. If you are interested, for WSET level 1, you can contact me. You can mail us on tastings@solovines.com or you can mail me mukesh.kumar@solovines.com. Right? If you guys are interested. Nowadays, we have been doing online WSET courses. So this is the best time for this. Okay? So now let me tell you about something, a brief introduction about the company. You know about Sula. Rajiv Samant is the founder of the company, right? And he is the CEO of the company. Okay, you can see this is a vineyard, and the picture you can see on the screen. This is Heritage Resort, the source. Why we call it the source? Because at this place there was a winery earlier. Now it's converted into a heritage resort. Everything, whatever Sula has gained till now, it was started from this place only. That's why this place name is the source. Source. This is the source of everything, right? Sula has 65% of market share and it's sourcing from 3,000 acre land. And let me tell you, the company was started from just 5 acre land in 1998. This is a very young wine, young company, young alcohol company, you can say. The name came from Rajiv Samant's mother name, Sulbha. Okay, you can see Rajiv Samant and Kerry Damski. Kerry Damski, Rajiv Samant is holding a Riesling glass in his hand in a blue shirt. Okay, he is the founder of the company, and Kerry Damski is the master winemaker. He ferments the wines, he ferments the grapes basically. Okay, done, guys. So, we have a tasting room in Nasik. Whenever you go there, go to tasting rooms, you can taste the wines there. Every year we have been getting 3 lakh people visiting the winery and tasting the wines there, right? We have 2 restaurants there, Soma and Little Italy. 2 restaurants are there. We also have been organizing Sula Fest. Sula Fest is a kind of musical event, wine, music, and international star, international artists perform there. Every year in the first week of Feb, we have been celebrating Sula Fest. Yes, amphitheater is the venue for Sula Fest. Beyond by Sula and the Source, these are the property that company owns. Nasik, Pune, Solapur and Karnataka, these are the wine producing region in India. We have 4 wineries are there. Sula owns 4 wineries. 2 units are in Nasik, 1 in Nasik. Second in Dindori, it's just 30 km away from first unit, and 2 units are in Karnataka. The climate in Nasik, it's very good, cool nights and warm days, right? It has a dry growing season, September to March, and rich wassail and dark soil is there. That is again very good. So common white wine grape varieties are there, Chenin Blanc, Sauvignon Blanc, Chardonnay, Riesling, and Viognier. So these are the white wine grape varieties we have been growing in Nasik. Cabernet Sauvignon is red, Merlot, Syrah, Shiraz, Primitivo, Zinfandel, Malbec, and Pinot Noir. So these are the red. So these are basically in French. To twist your tongue slightly when you're saying Cabernet Sauvignon, Syrah. Okay, these are in French, right? Malbec. And the last letter of the word is always silent. Cabernet. This is not Cabernet. It's Cabernet. Merlot, not Merlot. Okay? So, winemaking is done. So, guys, it's almost done. So, do you have any query, guys? You can ask me. Yes?
All right, so we are open for Q&A now. Yes. Any participant with question or certain queries on the topic? What is all about Sula Fest? What is who was the founder? Right, different types of grape, as rightly said. You know, you have to twist your tongue to pronounce the name correctly. So that's in French. The word that has been described was recently, just now. I mean, these are all French words. So you're going to learn French here at Servo as part of your curriculum. And then there are French terminology, which is there in food and beverage, services and production both. So, right? So So French has given so much to our industry that many of the cuisine, many of the beverages come from France. Many of the syrups, Monin, come from France. Right. So the manufacturing, the harvesting has been told by sir. So I would like to ask the participant if they have further queries. Anything, any question you can ask.
How I can stop this? Okay, I got it. Yes. Okay, I want to see all of you, actually. That's why I stopped it. How many attendees are there? Guys, can you switch on your videos, all of you, please?
Sanskar, Devansh, please put on your cameras. Sanskar Gupta. There are nine students, two faculty. I'll share the pictures with you, sir.
Please share the pictures with me, sir. Okay. So guys, any query, anything you want to ask about Sula, about wine? Yes?
So what is a desert wine?
Okay, desert wine. So desert wines are the sweet wine, basically.
So like red wine.
Yes.
Red wine or rosé wine?
What are rosé wine you asking now?
Sir, red wine or rosé wine are the sweet wines as well,
no? No, rosé wine you can say off-dry wine, not a sweet wine. See, off-dry means it has little sweetness. Sweet wines has plenty of sweetness. Okay? For the desert wine, for a sweet wine, so grapes are harvested when they are overripened. They are overripe. Okay, basically they have very less of water water proportion in the grape berry, and they are high in sweetness. So those grapes are used for making a desert wine. That is a sweet wine. Rosé wine, red wine, white wine, and rosé wine. What is the difference in the process of making these three wines? The only difference is the pressing. Taking out the juice. When you pressing your grapes, that makes the difference. For white wine, it's before the fermentation and white grapes are used. For red wine, after the fermentation and red grapes are used. Okay? And for rosé wine, during the fermentation process, within 2 days of fermentation and red grapes are used. Till the time you get a nice rosé color, till the time you can leave the skin during in the fermentation process, okay, and then you can press it. So fermentation chalta rehta hai aapka. Within 2 days you pressed it. What you have partially fermented grape juice, and fermentation is still on, but you have got the desired color, the rosé color. Okay, yes.
Sir, then what does particularly make the desert wine difference? Just the sweetness.
Sweetness only.
And what is the color for it?
It can be a bit pale. If it's high in sweetness, it can be a bit pale. With kind of you can say जैसे आपका हनी का होता है थोड़ा सा इस कलर का. अगर aged wine है आपकी sweet wine, aged wine है, honey के color जैसा भी आपका इसका जा सकता है, but the diluted one, not the.
It is made from red grapes only.
Sweet wines are made from white grapes only.
Desert
wine and the sweet wine are the same. Sweet means extremely sweet. There is a lot of sweetness. Its taste is like honey. Jitna sweet aapka honey hota hai, the sweet wine itni sweet hoti hai. Okay? Right? And rosé wines are made from red grapes. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Anything else you want to ask, guys? Any query?
Sir, can you give us some information on WSET courses?
WSET is Wine and Spirit Education Trust. There is only one organization in this world who qualify you as a sommelier.
Okay.
Right? So there are five levels. WSET level 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Once you have completed your fifth level, you are master of wine. You can go into winemaking. Right? Fourth level is the educator level. You can teach WSET level 1, WSET level 2, and you can also go to winemaking. And you are a good certified sommelier. You can go to hospitality industry as well. Level 3 is an advanced course for sommelier, for wines. Okay. You are a sommelier. I am WSET level 3 certified. Right?
Okay.
If I want to teach WSET level 1 and 2, I need to go for the educator course, level 4. Right?
Okay.
I want to work in the hospitality industry or in the alcohol industry. I'm good with WSET level 3. Level 2 is the intermediate course. And level 1 is the foundation course in wines.
Okay.
Right? So we have been doing so far one WSET level 1. And the fee fee structure for this is, I guess, 8,000 or 8,500 rupees only. Right?
All right.
So tasting is not possible to do nowadays. We have been tasting 10 to 15 wines in this WSET level 1. But nowadays, we can't taste the wines. We have been doing it online.
All right.
Right? So the certification you get from WSET London.
Okay, and the organization is situated in London, I believe.
In London, yes. Your copies goes to London.
Okay.
Copies go to London for checking. The results comes from the London itself. Okay.
All
MCQs
right.
are there. For WSET level 1, you need to score 70%.
All right.
Unless you have, otherwise you have to reappear for this.
All right, sir. All right.
Okay.
Right.
So in case you have you are interested for this, you can write me at mukesh.kumar@soloins.com or